It's a little bit quiet in here at the moment. Everyone is getting very excited because we are coming to you live from Lausanne, Switzerland for the Youth Olympic Games. This is an incredible event which we are so excited to be bringing you live on olympicchannel.com. So make sure you jump on there and download our app. We are covering this event here, there and everywhere. So jump on Instagram, check out the lowdown, and also if you want to hear a little bit more about what these athletes are up to, who they are, you can also listen to our podcast. But for now, thank you for joining us on our pre-show. We are warming up, like every athlete who has to warm up before they compete. We are warming you guys up at home before we get into our show, where we're going to meet some wonderful athletes and some athlete role models, athlete ambassadors who are joining us on the show today. So let's see who's sitting back and waiting to come and say hello. So far, we have got Fanny Smith, and we also have got Nathalie Pechalat. Good to have you guys with us. They're going to come down and join us on the sofa very shortly. Now, they have some insight on our theme, which is something that we want you guys to try and help us, you know, find the answer. The question is, how do figure skaters not get dizzy? I mean, I'm not too sure how it all works. We can ask Nathalie, as a figure skater, how that happens, because it is a tricky thing to try and do. Make sure you send in your comments. Let us know. We've already had a bunch of comments coming in. We've got people saying, I would think that they are in good health and have a lot of practice. So I imagine that that's the case as well. We've got people saying it's a mixture of spotting and getting used to it. I don't know if you can just naturally get used to it. I imagine it is a lot of practice, that is for sure. But it's great to have you guys with us. We've got lots and lots of comments coming through. Tell us where in the world you are watching from. Tell us which sports you are looking forward to seeing here at Lausanne 2020. And I'll make sure I get through some of those and we can make sure that we read them out. We've got a message here saying, I'm from Indonesia. We've got people here from Russia. It's great to have so many of you watching. Oh, someone from America and Italy, Brazil. A lot of comments coming through, so make sure you keep them coming in. We're going to go have a little walk down and find out who is out and around in this wonderful space. This is a space where athletes can hang out. I can see an athlete over here doing a bit of balancing on one of the things on the ground. I don't know if you can reach over there and see what's going on over there. They're always very active, these athletes. And of course, hello.
Hello.
We pre-planned this because you've got the microphone. How are you? Your name is Grace.
Grace,
and
yes.
Grace, you are competing in ski mountaineering, which is a new sport here at the Youth Olympic Games. Grace, how's it been going?
It's been going really well. Yeah, this is an amazing experience. And they have this so perfectly curated for all of us. And so it's been amazing just to meet all the athletes from the different countries and experience the competition here and all of the excitement of all the people watching.
What have you enjoyed most about this whole Lausanne 2020 experience? Because for a lot of people who don't know what it all means or what it's all about, might be a bit hard to understand.
Yeah.
But what's it been like? How would you try and describe what it is like?
Mm-hmm. I think the energy and just the connectedness is what I enjoy most. I've gotten to meet athletes from so many different countries. And I have never met athletes from a lot of these places and from a lot of these sports. So just learning about where they come from and what sports they do has been amazing and forges lifelong friendships. So I think that's my favorite.
It's really like a melting pot of languages, of cultures, of diversity. Can you speak any other languages? Have you?
Not really speak. I can read and write French, but I'm still working on my confidence.
Hey, you are in the right place to practice your French,
yes,
though, right?
Exactly.
And as a ski, we'll talk a bit more about your sport in the actual show, but as we're sort of talking a little bit more about the sports that are here, are there any other sports that really fascinate you?
I think biathlon is personally the sport that fascinates me most, just because they work just as hard as we do in competition, and then they have to stop and calm down enough to shoot a gun when their heart rate is that high and they're working that hard. So I think biathlon is my favorite to watch and is the sport that intrigues me the most.
We're going to have a little bit of biathlon on the show really shortly, so you can have a look at that as well. But what about summer sports? I mean, to keep fit in the summer, are there other sports that you do, or do you just chase winter all year round?
I love running almost as much as I love skiing. I have always run cross country and track, but this past year I ran a few ultra marathons. And that's what I plan on continuing to do in the summer. So, yeah.
Wow, there's no rest for the wicked. It's all go, go, go. And what about the opening ceremony? Because that happened, how many days ago was it? 2 days. It kind of becomes a bit of a blur, doesn't it?
For sure.
What did you make of that? Did you get to go along?
Yeah. I got to go along with my team and everyone else. It was an amazing experience. Seeing a stadium that full is just awe-inspiring. And seeing that many athletes, I think we see people around here, but you don't realize truly how many athletes are staying in the village. So
because everyone gets a bit spread out as well. Yeah. Everyone's kind of competing in different places. Do you think once you finish competing, you'll actually get to go and watch other sports?
Yeah, I think I'm hoping I'll get to see a few other events. But none of us are ever all together at one time. So it's really cool to see all of the athletes in one place.
Yeah, and now everyone's kind of running around and hopefully you'll get to see a little bit more action shortly, which will be very, very cool. Just very quickly, we're going to be asking these guys about how figure skaters, well, Nathalie in particular, is going to tell us how figure skaters don't get dizzy. Do you understand how they do it?
Not really, but I used to play soccer and our coach would always have us stand on one foot to warm up and look at a blade of grass. So I'm guessing it has something to do with where you look.
Might have something to do with that. Well, we are going to find out very shortly what that answer is. Make sure you keep with us for our live show. Hey guys, welcome to Lausanne. We are here in Switzerland for the Youth Olympic Games. Over the next 2 weeks, we're going to be celebrating everything youth, everything innovation, and everything sport as these athletes, almost 2,000 of them, I know, a lot of athletes, competing between the ages of 15 and 18. They're competing across 8 different sports, and we do truly hope to be bringing you the flavour of the games. And of course, a lot of the action is going to be on olympicchannel.com. So make sure you jump on there. And if you haven't already downloaded the app, make sure you download the app because you can see the action on there as well. We also have a podcast. Make sure you tune into that because that is going to talk to a few of the voices and a few of the people who are competing here. It really is something special. What are we doing now? Well, we are here bringing you a live show. We're in the Vortex. This is a space where the athletes are staying. This is where they stay, they sleep, they eat, and they hang out a little bit and get to know some other athletes. We have got some friends who are going to be joining us on the show. They're upstairs. Let's have a quick look at who have we got in the green room. You've already met one of them. It's Grace from the USA. We've got Fanny Smith, and we also have got Nathalie Pechalat. They are going to be joining us on the show very shortly. Now, earlier, you may have heard me mention that we have a theme for the show today. Our theme is how do figure skaters not get dizzy? If you've got any clues, then you should make sure you drop us a message and let us know. I'm getting a lot of messages from people already. Let me just try and read a few of them out. People are very excited. Someone's saying, although I get a little dizzy, keeping your eyes looking at the same thing kind of helps. Other people are saying, hello, Ash. Hello, Maria. Nice to have you writing into us. We've got people all around the world. We've got South Africa. We've got people from Tokyo. And we've got people saying they love figure skating. So wherever you are in the world, if you've got any comments or have got any questions that you want to ask me or us about the Youth Olympic Games, then make sure you send them on into us. We are going to now go and have a look at some of the action from today. Biathlon, 6 medals were given out, and this is the winner, Elena Mokova from Russia. Have a look at her moment right here. So there you have it. Wonderful moment. Can you imagine that? Crossing the finish line and knowing that you are a Youth Olympic gold medalist. Now, the medal ceremony is going to be happening in about an hour, and so she will be receiving her medal. What a magical moment that will be for her. Keep those comments coming in. It's great to have so many of you with us from all around the world. We are going to bring down a guest, and maybe you want to ask her some questions because she knows a thing or two about the Olympics, that is for sure. We've got someone saying, pick something huge on the wall and keep your eyes on it. So that is answering our question around how figure skaters manage to not get dizzy. So maybe we'll look into that a little bit more shortly. But for now, I think it's time that we bring down our first guest on the show. She's an absolute superstar and she knows a thing or two about the Olympics, having been to three Olympics before. Come on down, Fanny Smith. How are you?
Great, thank you.
Take a seat.
Thank you.
Sit down with us. I was just saying before that I recognised you from behind straight away when you came in to hang out with us because if you're here, because I saw it at the opening ceremony.
Quite long.
Yeah, it's very long. It's like your signature. How are you? Thank you so much for joining us.
I'm great. Just preparing for the next World Cup coming up next week for me.
Yeah, I feel like you are nonstop because you are a current athlete, so you're still competing, but you've taken a bit of time away from ski cross to be here as an athlete ambassador, as a role model. So what have been, I guess, your first impressions of this game so far?
Really great, actually. I see it really from the inside because I'm coming from here, and I mean, every people are so exciting about, oh well, we are going to see this event or this event, and I mean, we see really like the atmosphere, which is really awesome, actually, around the sport, and good spirit.
Yeah, and I guess the other thing is that these athletes are between the ages of 15 and 18, but their talent is phenomenal. Have you had a chance to see any action yet?
I haven't the chance still because I've been training myself, actually.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I saw it on TV, and really, I mean, as you say, now it's coming so quick, so good, actually, and you see the talented youth athletes who are here, actually, and the best one.
Is this something that you would have, you know, the Youth Olympic Games, is this something that you would have liked to have experienced?
Yes, of course, because I think, you know, you are straight on the big events and with such, you know, ambience and things like that. I've been straight away to the big Olympic Games when I was 17 years old. So that was, I mean, like, you know, straight on the...
Straight on the big stage.
Yeah, exactly. But for sure, I think it's really great for the youth athletes to pass through the Youth Olympic Games.
It's a lot of things to take in all at once, isn't it? You really have to kind of wrap your head around everything.
Yeah, for everything, as you say, like maybe it's your first time with TV, with all those things. I mean, you know, it's quite stressful. So you have, to be, I mean, you know, to be ready or, you know, to have in your mind and it's going to be crazy and, you know, you're just going
to
be running around and left. Yeah, so that's it.
To learn how to manage all those things. You mentioned TV. I wanted to put you on the spot a little bit. We have a segment called Breaking Stereotypes. And of course, with any sport, there are particular stereotypes. So I wanted to ask you a few stereotypes about free ski. Are you up for it?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see. I'm going to ask you a few questions and you basically say if it's correct, yes or no, and why.
Okay.
So my first one is skiers are always on the mountain earlier than snowboarders.
That's true. No, I mean, it depends. I mean, which sport in snowboard, but it's true. Like if you take the freestyler, they have to have kind of a soft snow. So that's normal, actually, because if they come really early, it's going to be really, really icy. And for them, you know, to land any jumps or to do the half pipe, it's going to be quite tricky. So it's understandable, I mean, you know.
That kind of goes into my next question a little bit. I was going to say, are snowboarders lazy?
No, I think, I need to say no, if not I'm dead when I'm going out from this show. But I mean, no, I mean, you know, it's different. It's different sport. And of course, you know, it's some things that you prepare, I mean, just differently than other like every sport, actually.
Is skiing easier to learn than snowboarding?
Difficult, because I did when I was young 1 year just snowboard. Wow. But I've been always a girl with doing longboard and skateboard from a really young age, so I was used to stand side, you know, sideways.
Yeah.
But I would kind of say, yeah, maybe at the beginning snowboard is difficult, more difficult.
What about this last question is, ski cross athletes are more prone to injury than other skiers?
No, I don't agree. I mean, no, it's like every sport, you have to prepare yourself to train for it, to accept, you know, the sport, and which for sure is quite big and intense.
So I guess the main thing is that you have to be fierce, you have to be focused.
Yeah.
I guess you just have to be super fit as well.
Yes, actually, that's quite of the main point. I mean, you know, you have to prepare your body. I'm pro ski cross athlete from I'm 16 years old.
Wow, that's a young age. You've got to build strong muscles from a young age.
Yeah,
to do
also,
that.
Yeah. So, but you have also to be careful because, you know, you are growing up and all those
developing
things. Yeah. But for sure, I've been, you know, quite focused about training to actually do my sport and, if possible, doing good.
Yeah, I guess you really have to make sure you sort of look after your body a lot. Mm. We've actually got some people who are big fans of yours, and they've been sending some messages in. I'm just trying to refresh this one. So we've got one from Sophia. She's saying, how did it feel when you found out that you would be competing in the Olympics?
I mean, that was pretty amazing. I was the youngest Swiss athlete competing in Vancouver 2010. So, I mean, yeah, that was kind of unreal, but in another way, my coach didn't want me to be too much in this crazy Olympic thing, so we went really late, actually, to the Olympic Village to be actually most focused on the race, but I think that was, for me, the best and nicest real Winter Olympic in Vancouver 2010.
We saw that footage from you from Pyeongchang, and you just looked like you were just having, I don't know, the time of your life, but it was also super close, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was quite tough. I mean, Pyeongchang was really intense. It's actually the game which I lived the most. I've been there and I say, yeah, it was my third Olympic Games. I was like, gosh, you know, just enjoy, try to live the moment, live the Olympic Games.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the race is starting. The first place was not too far away, so I wanted, you know, it's our sport, which is cool. You have this direct fight. And then I did quite a big mistake, who has cost a lot, actually. And actually, it was two races in one. I started first, tried to get this gold, and then I did a mistake, and I was just trying to get a medal.
Right.
At all. And
just trying to do whatever you could.
Yeah. And so that's the things you have really to, it's kind of, we always say, like, never give up, but it's really true, because in the race, things can change so quickly.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
you
yeah.
should really stay focused and say, still, I can still do it.
Just very quickly, I saw a question come up on the screen from Anna asking, what goes through your mind when you see that green light?
I mean, you know, it's for sure, it's good good spirit. In ski cross, we have this qualification alone, and then we go heat by heat. So when we are 4x4, it's kind of easy. We don't really have this green light because we see where you are. You know,
if you are
first or if you are fourth,
right.
You see the other competitor around. So I think that's what's the more gratifiant. I mean, which is great with our sport is. It's like, you know, when you were a child and say, oh, the first to the car, or, you know, something like that. You know if you
racing.
Win or not. It's constantly real racing.
Yeah, I guess that's the thing about most athletes that you meet, is they're always competitive no matter what they were doing.
Yeah, it is, it is.
Hey, look, I mentioned before that our team are all over this event. We are out and about everywhere. And Andrew is in St. Moritz. He's got a bit of an insight about some of the sliding that is going on down there.
Hi guys, Andrew here at the Olympia Bob Run in St. Moritz. As you can see, it's a super sunny day, but do not be fooled. It is about minus 12 degrees. Now, why is this important? Because this venue will host skeleton, bobsleigh, and the luge. And it's the most sustainable venue at Lausanne 2020 because it's built by hand every November. Now, it's super, super loud in there today. There's lots of excitement, the tannoy's going, but I want to give you an idea and a feel for what happens at this venue. So, this is where the athletes get delivered by the bus, either for their first run or if they're coming down for their second run. Now follow me and I'll take you to the warm-up area. As you can see, loads of people, loads of excitement, loads of music happening here. It's the bobsleigh practice day at the moment. Now this area here, marked out by the orange square, is where the athletes on the left of the sleds here will come to warm up. When their name is called, they then move into the office on the right of the start to keep warm. Their name is then called again, and it's their time to shine. The luge will be the first event that kicks off here on the 16th of January before the skeleton and the bobsleigh begin on the 19th of January. As you can see, the stunning venue is ready to roll, and St. Moritz is good to go.
Well, St. Moritz certainly looks like the place to be, doesn't it? Nice and snowy. Have you been there before?
I've never been to St. Moritz.
You've never been to St. Moritz?
No, I never. It's quite like the opposite way from where I live. So, no, but I hope soon I will go because it looks really nice.
Well, I mean, I guess you're too busy competing, right? Mm-hmm. And if you're not there, if you're not competing in an event that's in St. Moritz, you're probably going to be you know, elsewhere around the world.
Completely.
Let's bring in our next guest onto the sofa. I think there's a bit more room next to you,
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You've got lots of space. So, Nathalie Pechalat, why don't you come down and join us, figure skating star. Give her a big round of applause. Come sit down. You've already met Fanny, haven't you?
Yes. Good, and you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Hey, let's look at this footage. This is fantastic. You look like you're having the time of your life.
Yeah, it's a long time ago, you know. It's 6 years, and it just feels like it was yesterday. I still have the sensation, the feeling of the competition.
Yeah, when you watch moments like that, does it take you back? Does it take you back to when you were competing, or do you just sort of think like, oh yeah, that was just another day?
I don't know. It really brings me back to this period, and I'm very far from this style of life. Like, I don't wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning to be on the ice at 6. But when I watch the competition, it's I felt exactly the same energy I had in this period. So, but it's very relaxing for me to be here and to don't train anymore.
I was going to say, what is it like for both of you coming to a Games and not competing? Does it feel a little bit weird?
Yeah, actually, it was pretty weird. And on my social media, I put some things about opening ceremony. And some people think that I'm still racing it. And they're like, good luck, enjoy. And I was like, unfortunately, I'm too old.
Yeah. Yeah, my body doesn't understand. I wake up during the night, I'm like, I'm not trained enough.
Thinking about routines.
I'm not ready. Yeah. And no, I'm just here to be with the athlete. I'm not an athlete anymore. But it's very weird because it's like I got some signal that it's very wrong, but it's like there is a memory,
body
memory
knows.
And it's very weird.
Amazing. I mean, I guess it's so nice to be sitting next to, I guess, two people who are so passionate about sport, because everyone here loves sport so much. And, oh, I can see a question on the screen. Our fans are super passionate about sport, and they want to know, who chooses the music for skating? Is it the dancers or is it the coaches?
There is no rules. A lot of team, it's the coach who decide, but more and more now it's the dancer, because you need to appropriate the music, the history you want to tell. So I guess, I'm sure it's better if the skater choose, because it's your if it's a coach, he can give the music to you or somebody else. If you choose, it's your baby.
And I guess it feels like your sort of your rhythm. You get to really feel it out, right?
Yeah.
Did you have a favorite song that you danced to?
I love music and I love songs, so I always find a way to appreciate something. Mm. But I don't have one favorite. I love everything. The swing, the tango, all the Latin dance, or the actual music, actually. Oh, waltz, I love everything.
I love everything. Yeah. Can you just pick I'm all, just select yeah. all? Hey, we have a theme of the day, and the question is, how do figure skaters not get dizzy? Can you enlighten us?
Yeah, there is no secret. You need to train a lot to get used to it. But the first advice I can give to some skaters, watch, it's we have to have a good core, to avoid the balance between forward and backward on the blades, and to keep the shoulders very straight. Don't bench right and left. And like that, you can teach to your equilibrium.
Yeah, you your know, brain.
Equilibrium.
Yeah.
The here. Yeah. It's not just about the view, the eyes. You need, yeah, there is two methods. Or you fix a point, you turn, and you fix again the point. Or you fix just a line
across
at your eyes level. So there is two methods, and then you got used to it with the,
you know, oreille interne.
Yeah, oreille interne inside here. And when you get used to that, you know where is your body in the space, you know how to move your body, and you can start to do difficult position like the layback or the camel. Yeah, but no secret, just need to do it and do it again and
well,
again.
Well, how would you feel about doing it with us? Do you think we could do a demonstration?
I can try.
Yeah, yeah, let's do it. Let's
long
give
time
it a go.
I didn't do
we'll
that.
See if some of these guys want to give it a go as well. So let's go downstairs.
Okay.
So if you lead the way, Fanny, you just walk down there.
I'm coming.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you're coming. So if you walk down this way, we'll just walk over to the right-hand side. Hi, okay. Guys, how are you going? Would you like to come join us? We're doing some figure skating practice. Come join us.
Toujours été si impressionnée.
Okay, so, Nathalie, can I put you over this side?
Yes.
Fanny's over here. Okay. You guys come and join us as well. We're going to do a lesson how would you explain it? On how to make sure you don't get dizzy when you spin. So you guys aren't figure skaters, are you?
No.
No? Come on in. You're a biathlete. Oh, come on in. Come in, come in, come in, come in. All
great.
Right, so.
So we have to imagine we have one vertical line.
Okay, can we all imagine the vertical line?
So try to touch the sky and put the pressure on the foot and keep the shoulder very in line. Don't bench. So you have like a cross. Yeah. And then or you fix a point, you turn and you fix a point again. Or you just keep your eyes at the same level.
So
and you do it slowly, and then you go quicker
faster.
And quicker. Yeah.
Okay, so everyone's okay, got a little bit of space.
Do we start with the shoulder turning or with the hip?
It depends on the like out the edge.
Okay, yeah, the edge.
But you can
so if you want to come over here, you come join me. Get you to turn around. You turn around, you can stand in front of me there.
But you can turn.
And you can turn around. We've got the camera right there. Keep looking at the camera.
All
right, so ready?
You can use your upper body to take the speed.
So pick your spot. Everyone pick a spot in front of them. Look at the camera. Pick your spot and turn. I'm going to take someone out if I do it, so I won't do. She's still got
it. So elegant.
She's still got
it. So elegant.
So elegant, Nathalie. That's amazing.
Put your arms up if you want, or you do
back.
What you want after. At least you have the
cross. Ah, that's pretty good.
You're a pro. So you guys are biathletes?
Biathletes.
All right. Well, great figure skating lesson. That's amazing. We are going to be celebrating all of the wonderful moments that you guys are going to be out there doing, creating. And each day we're picking out a moment of the day or someone special who has done something really nice. And this time, I love how you're like looking down at my notes. And we can read them together. Israel's 17-year-old Noah Solas was the first Israeli athlete to ever win an Olympic medal at a Winter Youth or Winter Olympic Games. And have a look at this. This was her success story, a bronze and a silver. I mean, that is what it is all about. What an amazing moment.
I mean, she made history for her country. I mean, it's she will have this feeling forever, and it will motivate herself to go even further.
Yeah, what an amazing moment. Honestly, just watching those scenes makes my heart just go bang, bang, bang. Hey, we have got one more other special guest who's lonely and probably waiting to come on down. So Grace Staberg, why don't you come on down and join us. Ski mountaineering star. Let's have a little bit of a look about what ski mountaineering is all about. Grace, thank you so much. I'll give you that.
Okay.
Welcome. Thank you so much for coming down. You've brought some bits and pieces with you, but we'll talk about that shortly. You are doing ski mountaineering, which is a new sport here at the Youth Olympics. You competed for the first time yesterday. Bit of a difficult day, heartbreaking and amazing all at the same time. Explain a little bit what happened.
Yeah, so I came across the finish line in third. I had a tough first half of the race, but I managed to fight back to third. And then I was given a penalty for a technicality that was 3 minutes. And so that pushed me back to seventh place.
Wow. That must be so hard to take. How are you after that? Must be a difficult thing for any athlete to cope with that sort of thing. But that's sport, right?
Yeah, of course. It was really disappointing in the moment, but it was a great learning opportunity. I will never make that mistake again. And I'm still really proud of myself for the race I laid down. Yeah, and I think it's lit a fire under me for my next race, so all good things.
And as you're right, you are getting to race again, so you've got another chance to get back. Let's have a little look in this bag. Have you guys got anything, any idea of what a ski mountaineer would have in their bag?
I know because I do a bit, but just for fun.
Oh, there we go. Have you got any idea what the ski mountaineer has?
Absolutely not. I guess no ski.
No skis.
No, my skis are still at the ski hill.
Yeah. So, Grace, if you can open that up and show us a little bit of what you've got in here.
Yeah. Sorry, there's a lot in here. It's pretty full. My gloves, of course.
So that's key to keep your hands warm and to actually be able to hold on to your poles, right?
Yes. And then this is a survival blanket. We have to carry it for all of our races. I can't imagine ever needing to use one in a short race. But just in case anything happens, these would keep us warm. Mm-hmm. I always carry my passport with me. You have to have some form of identification.
So you, wait a minute, you race with your passport in your backpack?
Yes, but I have this handy little waterproof bag to keep my passport safe and dry.
That is amazing. Yes. I wonder the places that this passport has been.
What is the reason?
I can only imagine.
Yeah, and then this is a probe. The shovel and the probe would be used to help locate people and then dig them out if we were ever caught in an avalanche.
Right.
So these are really important, although our shovels are really, really teeny. So I don't think you could actually do that much, but they would help in an emergency.
So this is kind of the bulk. This is the main sort of stuff, right?
Yep. And then these, I would say, are the most important. These are your skins.
And so this was a little bit of part of what happened with...
Yes.
With your incident,
it was
wasn't
poking
it?
out of my suit, so that was the issue. But these are the most important piece of gear, apart from our skis and bindings and boots.
I wanted to ask these guys, now that we've gone through the bag and you pulled out those skis, that was poking out, so that was what got you the penalty. I mean, for you guys as athletes, what advice do you have for Grace to sort of get up to move past this and to, I guess, make the most of this wonderful opportunity at the Youth Olympics?
I think it's, as she say, she has learned a lot about what happens, and it's just bring her more motivation to doing well. Every time you have, you know, some bad days, you always take the most positive things as you do, and it's just help you to go forward.
Yeah, it's never a line, a career, so you have up and down and just have to just continue and build your confidence and build your practice. Just move on.
Yeah. I have to say I'm incredibly proud to have you women here on the show today. This Youth Olympic Games is gender equal, so there's half men, half women, but it's so wonderful to have so many inspiring young women here to make this Youth Olympic Games something really, really, really special. Sorry, I'm getting a bit tongue-tied, so excited. Now, something that is also going to be happening in about an hour's time is the medal ceremony. So we can't go into the future, but we can go back and show you what happened last night at Medals Plaza. Amazing moment here, athletes being given their medals. We've got a lot of excitement here because they're talking about everything that's in the bag. We'll leave these guys to keep talking about it. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to you guys for joining us. No, you're good. I love that you're so passionate about what is in the bag, because that's what this is all about. It's about sports, it's about cultures, mm-hmm. It's about different people sharing this wonderful experience. So thank you for joining us.
Lovely. Thank you.
And all the very best for the rest of your competition this year. Thank you for joining us. Keep inspiring the future, and for you, keep doing your thing. Thank you so much for joining us, guys.
Bye.
See you next time.